good to see you. Get up off here on your feet. I'm choosing heaven today. I'm choosing heaven today. I am walking the road, heaven right now, singing. I'm choosing heaven today. Peace. I'm choosing peace today. I'm choosing peace today. I am walking the road, heaven right now, singing. I'm choosing peace today. Love. I'm choosing love today. Choosing love today. I am walking the road of heaven right now, singing. I'm choosing love today. Heaven. I'm choosing heaven today. I'm choosing heaven today. I am walking the road of heaven right now, singing. I'm choosing heaven today. You guys look good out there.
Look good out here. We're all good looking. Come on.
Thank you.
I said, what's so funny, Felina? We're all good looking. What's the problem? Inside and out. Thank you very much. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Center for Spiritual Living, Parker. I'm Reverend Stephanie Stewart. Here at CSL Parker, it is our mission to provide spiritual tools for personal and community transformation. We fulfill our mission with this Sunday gathering by offering classes and workshops throughout the week, and by being of service to both the town of Parker and to the larger world. Today is, of course, 9/11, September 11th. So we mark that day with solemn hearts, for sure. I also want to read the thank you letter that we received concerning our August donation drive for the Colorado Coalition for the Homeless, simply because, excuse me, I swallowed wrong earlier and I'm just hoarse now. Our donation specifically went to veterans. So this says, on behalf of the Rocky Mountain Regional VA Medical Center patients and staff, we would like to extend our appreciation to you for your donation of blankets, hygiene items, and socks. It is through the efforts of community partners like you that allow us to continue the quality care and services that we seek to provide for our deserving veterans. We look forward to the opportunity to work with you again for future events. Thank you for your continued support and advocacy. Sincerely, Eva Gersley, Chief Center of for Development and Civic Engagement. And there's a handwritten note here that says, thank you all so much. So please know you did very good work in this world. Please also know that we are looking for an October donation recipient. So if you know of a charity that could use our donations in the month of October, please get with me after service today. If you are with us for the very first time, a very special welcome to you. If you're willing to raise your hand, thank you. Do we have a welcome packet for this person? Welcome packet? Kenny? Can you grab a welcome packet? They'll bring you a welcome packet in just a second. In that welcome packet, you'll find a welcome card. If you would be so kind as to fill that out, that lets us get to know you a little bit better, and it allows you to get our e-newsletter. You'll just drop that card in the offering basket as it goes by. That lets you know what's happening here at our center. So joining me at the podium today will be Anne Grove to offer our interfaith candle lighting reading, spiritual reading, and an invocation. Lighting our candles today will be Irene McKnight. Anne is a licensed prayer practitioner. Our practitioners can be identified by their white and gold stoles or their purple stoles. Practitioners have gone through 4 years of training to be able to see the spiritual truth of any situation for you. So no matter what is happening in your life, good, bad, whatever it is, sit with a practitioner. They will be able to see the spiritual truth for you. I encourage you to sit with somebody in one of these beautiful stoles after service today. We have a nice little area right over there set up for you. Sit with them, talk with them, ask them to pray with you. So now it's time for some more great music, today led by Lisa Guilfoyle.
Beyond measure, I am peace here and now. I am wholeness, thriving perfection.
Good morning. At Center for Spiritual Living Parker, we honor all paths to the divine. This candlelighting ceremony highlights seven of those paths. Our theme for this month is work. We light the first candle in honor of Islam. Let the beauty of what you love be what you do. We light the second candle in honor of Christianity. The power of one, if fearless and focused, is formidable, but the power of many working together is better. We light the third candle to honor Buddhism. Your work is to discover your work, and then with all your heart, to give yourself to it. We light the fourth candle to honor Confucianism. Choose a job you love, and you'll never have to work a day in your life. We light the fifth candle to honor Hinduism. Communication is the real work of leadership. We light the sixth candle to honor Judaism. Everything that is really great and inspiring is created by the individual who can labor in freedom. And we light the final candle to honor Jainism. The happiest people are givers, not takers. Today's reading comes from Practicing the Presence by Joel Goldsmith. This reading in particular is enhanced by spirit to be large enough for me to read it. All the discords and inharmonies of the world come from the personal sense of I, from the sense that I am the source, that I am the doer. that I am something or other, but I am nothing of myself. The Father is that which I am, and I am but the instrument for the Father, the instrument of the Father's glory, the instrument of the Father's life, the lamp through which his light may shine. Rejoice because your names are written in heaven. Rejoice that you have found your identity as a child of God. Rejoice that you have awakened into the heavenly consciousness. If the Spirit takes hold of your hand and begins to write, if the Spirit takes hold of your voice and makes it sing, follow the lead of Spirit. Until that time, live your normal, natural life. But from morning till night and night until morning, remember to acknowledge that it is the infinite invisible that is producing the harmony, the joy, the peace, the prosperity of the visual of the visible experience. As human beings, we place our reliance on persons, places, things in the outer world, on education, money, bonds, or investments. That man who has his being in spirit places his entire reliance on spirit and trusts it to bring forth all that is necessary to the outer realm. Whenever faced with some need or desire, let us realize spirit as the source of its fulfillment. Let us realize spirit as the law unto it, even the law of multiplication, should it be necessary. Then let us go ahead about our business, whatever it may be, taking such human footsteps as may be necessary at the moment. This is living a normal, natural life, but letting the spirit, the invisible infinite, be the law of it, the substance of it, the cause of it, and the harmonious maintainer and sustainer of it. Knowing this to be true, let's pause for a brief meditation, a brief prayer. Pause and know that we are one. That we are one together, that we are one in spirit. And as we come here, the one that each of us is becomes the many. And the many is so powerful. That power is amplified by our service today. That power is enjoyed. This service today presents exactly what we need, what each of us individually and all of us collectively are willing to hear, are ready to hear. I know that the message is blessed, and each one of us is blessed as well. So please join me in affirming this by saying, and so it is.
Tiny drops of water bouncing on my roof, drumming out a song of love, pounding out the truth. You send them to remind me, one for every blessing on me. And oh, they keep coming, overflowing. Every day your goodness finds me. Every day your heart beats true. I'm alive in the light and the glory, amazed by the sight of you. This love is everlasting, and you find a way to show me. Every day, in a rush of freeway traffic, hush of a sunset, you get my attention. I'm listening. It's a private conversation, you and I in one.
Lisa. Before I start with my talk, I actually want to talk a little bit about Jainism, because I've been asked a few times now. The last reading, the last candle, comes from Jainism or Jainism. I've heard it pronounced both ways, Jains or Jains, J-A-I-N. This is a religion that's almost solely in India, because it's a religion of no harm. If you think Buddhism is a religion of no harm, the Jains have them beat. obviously, the vegetarians, many of them will wear a mask so that they don't accidentally breathe in an insect. Wherever they walk, they sweep a broom in front of them. And during the monsoon season, they will not travel at all. And there is at least one sect of them, they're all men, they don't even wear clothes. So that's what Jains are. So that last reading, I've had a couple people ask, now, what's Jainism? It's very rare. It's very rare, but it's really about absolutely doing no harm to another living being. So I'm going to start off with a quote today. Before you tell your life what you intend to do with it, listen for what it intends to do with you. Before you tell your life what truths and values you have decided to live up to, let your life tell you what truths you embody, what values you represent. That's from Parker Palmer. He's a writer and educator. So today's talk is called Creating a Life That Matters. Creating a Life That Matters. And there are three parts to this. There's listening to the voice within, telling us what is ours to do. Allowing that into our lives and letting our lives speak for us. And then doing the healing work we're called to do. Listening, allowing, and doing. Listening, allowing, and doing. So the definition of vocation, V-O-C-A-T-I-O-N, vocation, is this. A strong feeling of suitability for a particular career or occupation. Now, vocation comes from the Latin word vocare, vocare. And it means to call, or to invoke, or to summon. The divine calls us to our vocation. And no, it may not be the job that pays our bills, but it is our life work. Vocare. To call, to invoke, to summon. It also means voice. It's the voice of spirit talking to us, and then it is our job to listen. The Quakers say, let your life speak. Let your life speak. That means we make room within ourselves and in our lives and in our hearts to hear the voice of the divine speaking to us. A vocation isn't a job. It's what we're called to do. Now, people think only ministers are called, but that's not true. We're all called to many things in our lives. We can be called to a job. Absolutely, we can be called to a job. We can be called to a hobby, to our family, to our volunteer work, to our communities. Most importantly of all, though, we are called to our relationships. And one of those relationships is with God or Spirit or the divine or whatever you want to call it. We're called to our relationships, even the rotten ones. I firmly believe that. Our relationship with God is a two-way street. Okay, our relationship with Spirit is a two-way street. Most of us weren't taught to believe that, that it's a conversation. But we ask, and Spirit answers. Spirit is, it answers in so many different ways. Spirit is always talking to us. If we'll just listen. Now, how do we listen? The way we listen to anyone, we stop talking. Stop talking. The way we really listen to a fellow human being is we set an intention. We set an intention to hear. We listen to hear, not to respond, but to hear. Listening to hear is a bit of a lost art. It starts with setting an intention. Sit down and set the intention to hear God. Sit down with the intention to have a conversation with Spirit. Then just listen. If it turns out to be a meditation for you, all the better. But there's nothing magical about having a conversation with God. Matthew 7:7 and 7:8 says, "Ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives. The one who seeks finds. And to the one who knocks, the door will be opened." God doesn't play hide and seek with us. We just tend to play deaf. So get quiet and talk to God about your purpose. Talk to God about your life work, your vocation. Just be quiet for a little bit and listen. Then we have to let our lives speak for us. Our vocation is a statement of how we intend to belong to the world. Our vocation is a statement of how we intend to belong to the world. Who are you? How are you in this world? How do you intend to belong to the world? Do you believe that not only are you blessed, but you are also a blessing? Do you believe that? Not only are you blessed, but you are also a blessing. You are a blessing on this world and to everyone you meet. When we listen to God about our life work, our vocation, we come to know we are a blessing on this world. That's a bright light to shine. And it's a light that's needed right now in this world. That's allowing our lives to speak for us. That's allowing the holiness of our wholeness to speak for us. That's allowing the holiness of our wholeness to speak for us. When we're engaged in our calling, our wholeness is most evident. Now, don't misunderstand. We are always whole. We may not feel like it, but at our deepest, truest point, we are always whole, perfect, and complete. Always. But when we allow our calling to show up and speak through us, our wholeness is closest to the surface and the most visible. And we are at the zenith of our healing ability. So how will you bless this world? How will you bless this world? How will you belong to it? And remember, these questions that I'm asking, they aren't questions you have to answer. These are questions that you ask God. And then we listen for answers. How will you bless this world? How will you belong to it? And again, it doesn't have to be our job. Think about Lisa here. I'm sorry, I'm just going to embarrass you a little bit. She makes these wonderful blankets, right? She made me another one. Let me get it. Now, look at this. This is just a scrap for my little 8-pound dog. But she crochets these edges. She made a bunch of these for our homeless coalition drive. Can you imagine being homeless and being handed a homemade blanket? I mean, that doesn't just warm bodies, it warms hearts, it warms souls. And it may seem like a hobby to you, but I also see it as a calling on your life. It's Kenny and Amy and Vicky with our altar. It's Vicky and Denise and a bunch of other people with our refreshment table. It's the band and their amazing music. It's whatever you do with great love. It's whatever you do with great love. And you may feel like, well, this is just something that I do. But it's more than that. It's a call on your life. It's a call to create community, to celebrate humanity, to take us to a deeper spiritual space. And when any of us engage in our calling, our wholeness shows. We are a blessing on the world. Our life speaks for us because we allow our blessings to come through. Thomas Merton was an American Trappist monk and a 20th century mystic. And he said, discovering vocation does not mean scrambling towards some prize just beyond my reach, but accepting the treasure of true self I already possess. Allow the thought to come into your heart that you are a blessing on this world. It's true. You can deny it all you want, but I know it's absolutely true. When you are engaged with your calling and expressing wholeness, you are a blessing on this world. So finally, then, we have to ask ourselves, what is mine to do? What is mine to do? We listen for our vocation, what we're called to do. We allow that our calling can be a blessing on this world, that we express wholeness in a broken world when we engage in our vocation. So now it's time to go out and do it. How will we be in the world as our beautiful, whole selves? Maybe you give away your blankets. Maybe you pick just the right music. Maybe the altar you create evokes a deep spiritual feeling. Maybe the coffee you made helps facilitate a new friendship. What matters is that we move into action. Our vocation is something we must do once we understand what it is. Living our life as a calling or vocation is not something that can only live in the mind. It must come into this world of form. We have to go do it. Oh, that's like work. I don't want to go do it. Oh. Whether our calling is big or small, we have to go do it. And let me tell you something. The way becomes so clear when we say yes. The way becomes so clear when we say yes. When we say yes to the callings of our lives, the way just opens up. If we need money, it arrives. If we need mentors, they show up. If we need a place to express our calling, it falls into our lap. We just have to say yes. Creating a life that matters involves integrating our vocation into our lives so that we can take action. It involves growth and maturation and becoming our truest self. It's accepting our wholeness and expressing it unapologetically. And expressing it in a world that needs it. American writer and theologian Frederick Buechner defined vocation as the place where your deep gladness meets the world's deep need. The place where your deep gladness meets the world's deep need. Notice he doesn't start with the world's deep need, but with us. He starts with our joy and our gladness. We express wholeness when we're in that place. The needs of the world don't express wholeness. We do, in our joy and in our gladness. To create a life that matters is to listen for our calling. Allow it to be true in our lives and then go out and do it. It may be our work, it may be our job, but it's just as likely to be our hobby or something we think we just do because we like it. We are called to be here for one another. It shows up in an endless number of ways, and no expression of one's calling is greater than any other. Just because you don't reach millions with your calling, just because you don't change the world because of your vocation, it doesn't make it less. One life is enough. One life is enough. Because that life is changed for the better forever. Now, I started today with a quote from Parker Palmer. He said, "Before you tell your life what you intend to do with it, listen for what it intends to do with you. Before you tell your life what truths and values you have decided to live up to, let your life tell you what truths you embody and what values you represent." Listen. Let life speak to us, for us, and through us. We are each God's blessing on this earth. We are each God's blessing on this earth. Whatever we are called to do. Vicky kept after me about letting her do the coffee each week, and I was worried about her getting burned out. But I finally had to accept that hospitality was so important to her that it had taken on the level of a calling. So I had to get out of the way. Don't mess with Vicky. Our very own pixie. A calling will not go away if it's ignored. A calling will not go away if it's ignored. It will keep harassing you. Almost every minister alive knows the calling harasses you until you answer. But it's easier for us, it's easier for ministers, because people recognize being a minister is something one is called to do. But we are all called. We are all called. We all have callings on our life. Listen. Say yes. Accept and allow that you are a blessing. Accept and allow that you are a blessing. Say yes and go do it. Whatever you are called to, Spirit speaks to us if we will only listen. Be silent and listen and say yes. And go change the things that you're called to change. We are absolutely needed. And so it is. Shall we pray? So centered here and now in this space, this time where Spirit is, where God is, where the Holy One simply is, within me and within everyone here, all around us, expressing, loving, being, wholeness, love, joy, peace. I am so very grateful. I am so grateful to be able to express my calling on this morning. I am so grateful for everyone here and everything that is called to them, the callings on their lives, be it music or food or the altar or blankets or just giving hugs, just being. their perfect, whole, complete selves. This is what we are. This is who we are. And I am so deeply grateful for it. And so I release this prayer into a law that only says yes to us, that only says yes to our wholeness, yes to our oneness, yes to our love. It just says yes. I release this and I let it go and seal it with me by saying, and so it is.
There is no one like you. There is no one like you every day. Every day.
It's now time for our offering. Please know that your gifts and offerings are used responsibly as we fulfill our mission of providing spiritual tools for personal and community transformation. Money is God in action, and your money changes things for the better. Whether here at this center or in the community of Parker or even in the world, you are doing good work by giving. So know that when you give, you are more open to receive all the good in this world that is yours. And so it is.
Okay, you guys, let's see you get into the mood. This is our offering time. We're gonna mix it up a little bit. It's all good. All right, you guys, ready? One. Pretend you're out on the beach barefoot. Look up into the big blue. Watch the seagulls go by. Get a little Jimmy Buffett going here.
There are at least 100 ways my good is coming to me. There are at least 100 ways my good is coming to me. There are at least 100 ways my good is coming to me. There are at least 100 ways. My good is coming to me. At least 100 ways for me to receive the countless blessings, and so I believe. There are at least 100 ways my good is coming to me. There are at least 100 ways my good is coming to me. My good is coming to me. My good is coming to me.
Love it. I love it. Oh, Kenny, come with me. Thank you. Thank you to Kenny Johnson Day, one of our practitioners, for her service as usher. Yes, and everything else that you helped with. So I just know that these gifts and offerings are a blessing and bless us and bless the greater community. And I know those who give are now a little more open to receive. And so it is. So I get to do announcements today. See if I remember all of them. I have some of them written down and I have to remember at least two. So as always, our practitioners host a meditation practice from 9:30 to 9:50 on Sunday mornings. So don't miss out on that. Next week, I will speak on the topic of living your dream. My current blog post is called The Work of Wonder. Be sure to check that out. Beginning this Thursday, I will be teaching the class Foundations of the Science of Mind. It's from 6:30 to 8:30 Thursday evenings for 10 weeks. The investment is only $145. As its name implies, this is a foundational class to learn about our philosophy. It's also a life changer. It certainly was for me anyway. I mean, I wouldn't be standing here if I hadn't taken it. It's also a prerequisite for any of the certified classes offered through Centers for Spiritual Living. Yes, it's on Zoom. It's on Zoom. Thank you. Okay. I see you. No, Kathleen, I see you. We're bringing in a small collection for a bag. We need a bag for the band. This bag that we have, it holds all of the hardware that holds the drum set together. And it's in bad shape. It's very, very heavy, and the wheels are broken off of it. So if you are willing to make a donation, please come see me after service today, and we will see what we can do about getting a new bag. Also, if you would like to bring food in the future, there is a sign-up sheet on the table. Yes, there it is. I see it. There's a sign-up sheet. Please sign up to bring food in so we know what's coming in and we know what we have to deal with. I don't know. There's Colleen, though. There she's right there. People are screaming for peach cobbler, Colleen. Oh, no, the power went out in the middle of it baking. One last announcement then. This coming Monday is the September meeting of your Board of Trustees. Please note that the time has been changed to 4 p.m. rather than 6 p.m. because of football. If you would like to attend in person, please see a board member for the address. You can also attend via Zoom. That link is in the current e-newsletter. If you don't get that, let me know, and we will make sure that you get that. So thank you to everyone who served in any way today. Thank you to our practitioners, our camera operator, Renee Lapine. Don't give me that look. Special thank you to the amazing CSL Parker Band. And thank you to all of you for being here today. Now please join me in, thank you. Please join me in one last prayer. So I just know that we are joy, and we are wholeness, and we are oneness, and we are a blessing. We are a blessing on everyone we meet, in every situation we enter into, because we know we are perfect, whole, and complete, deep inside. And so I just know that we have a good week. I know that we all travel home in safety. And I know that we are centered in love. And so it is. Have a great week, everyone.
And if I take one step in the right direction, and if I touch one mark along the way, a chain reaction, and my journey has not been in vain. If I take one step in the right direction, and if I touch one heart along the way, then that one step becomes a chain reaction, and my journey has not been in vain. Take it away, Dan. Touch one heart along the way, and that one step becomes a chain reaction, and my journey has not been in vain. Yeah! If I take one step, if I touch one journey has not been in vain, and my journey has
It's love.